Hello and welcome back to the Entertainment Vortex. We were at Brendan Theaters today watching Red Sparrow. So going into this movie, you really don't get a whole lot from the trailers. It's really mostly just female-led spy thriller. Kind of gave me some Atomic Blonde type vibes, that sort of a thing. Which is not a bad thing at all for me. I really enjoyed that film. I gave it a great review last year. So at this point, I'm just excited to see how it turned out. I felt like this movie had an interesting story. Something that had a lot of heavy twists and turns. Something that you really find yourself just kind of pondering as you're watching it. Like, what's going to happen next? Who's doing what? You know, it does have that kind of like spy thriller type vibe to it. You know, where you're not sure who's on what side and you're trying to get things figured out. And it's great for the kind of people who sit in the theater and like to analyze something. It definitely has those types of qualities that make you really want to sit and think about what's going on screen.
When I went to see this movie tonight, I was expecting kind of an Atomic Blonde action, martial art, well, not martial arts, but an action type movie, but it's more of an espionage thriller. So this movie isn't really my kind of movie per se. It was very well made, a little slow paced. Jennifer Lawrence gives a great performance. I can't tell you whether her Russian accent sounds legit or not. It sounded real to me. I didn't really catch her. It's a light accent. It's not heavy. So I didn't catch any times when she slipped in her accent like the way Kiefer Sutherland did in that movie Pompeii, which I don't know what the fuck that was.
There are some lulls during the actual storytelling process. And the pacing can be up and down. With this type of movie, you do end up with some long stretches in the middle where you just have exposition, exposition, exposition. And the gaps in between the action scenes or in between like the heavy conversations that really mean something, it can make you really like analyze and pick at those lulls in the middle a little too much. And sometimes, like I said, depending on how good you are with these kinds of movies, it can be something where you may end up finding something out too early, or you may end up letting your mind go off on a track in a completely different direction. And then when it hits you with a thing that you weren't expecting, it shocked you even more. There are some pros and cons to that type of film style. Sometimes it can cause people to kind of check out in the middle, but like as far as I'm concerned, I feel like the pacing had some issues, but it wasn't something that took me out of the movie. I was still able to get engaged with the characters and enjoy what they were doing.
Nothing really unique about the cinematography, except to say that I noticed that Russia really loves their large rooms. You got the large dancer, the large auditorium, the large swimming pool area, the large restaurant, the large hotel rooms, except the hospitals. They got really dinky smaller rooms with glass walls on each side. I mean, that's... I would not want to be in a hospital like that for very long.
This movie is incredibly graphic in every sense of the word. There's sexually explicit content, like borderline gore and torture. This movie has a lot going on as far as earning that R rating. If you're not going and expecting that, it can definitely shock you. The acting performances in this, specifically Jennifer Lawrence as the lead, were absolutely outstanding. This is one of her best roles to date, in my personal opinion. She steals the show when she's on screen, which is important for your lead. She's just interesting to watch. Like, the way that she chooses to portray the character, the way that she delivers her lines, everything just has this great flow to it. And she just really has a knack for, like I said, drawing in attention. It plays really well as far as like the character is concerned. Like, she kind of has to be a person that's able to draw attention when she needs to, you know. Based on what you see from the trailer, she does, you know, she kind of falls into this type of like a spy espionage type life. And sometimes you need to be able to hide in plain sight, and sometimes you need to be the center of attention, and she's great at doing that. Joel Edgerton also puts in a solid performance. I feel like he doesn't necessarily stand up to the Jennifer Lawrence's performance, but it's definitely not an issue when he's on screen. Like I said, he has a character that has some legitimate motivations. It's easy to follow him, but like I said, Jennifer Lawrence is the real star of this show, and she shines in every aspect of the work. The way that they use music ties into the story in an interesting way. It's not something where they use a lot of like really well-known like current songs or anything like that. For the most part, it's classical music pieces. They create an interesting flavor in a lot of the scenes, and like I said, the way that they use it to actually engage with the characters is super interesting and intriguing to watch. Like I said, it adds a level of quality to this kind of a film.
I honestly don't have much to say about this movie. It was very well made, very well acted, but it was a bit slow for me. And I'll be honest, I had a little trouble following the plot. When it comes to espionage, spy thrillers, I do have a hard time following them because of their slow pacedness. Not a fault on the movie's part, just my own personal taste of film is a little different than what this was.
So overall, I would give this movie an 8.5 out of 10. I really enjoyed it. It's something that I want to watch again just to kind of see if there's any little tiny pieces that I missed. These types of movies are notorious for that. Like I said, second watchings, third watchings can sometimes illuminate places that were previously dark. That's the kind of movie that you really want to sit down and invest in multiple times.
Overall, I'm going to give this a 7.5 out of 10 for pacing, but the acting performances, the cinematography, and the plot overall, a little convoluted for me, but very well constructed, I felt, and that's that.
So we're curious to know, what's your favorite Jennifer Lawrence movie? Go ahead and leave that down in the comment section below. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. We post 4 videos a week as a minimum. This is the place to be if you want to check out gaming content, pop content, movie reviews. This is the place to be for those things. I hope you'll follow us into the vortex. We'll see you next time.